Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Guess what we're doing? It's 5-Fortress. If I'm not mistaken, that Koopa Kid is Iggy. I think because Vandalia said that the only one with glasses is Iggy, and I think it looks like he's got glasses. I hope that's not just like goggles or something, but I'm guessing it's glasses. I'm hoping it's glasses, so I'm just gonna say it's glasses. I didn't look up the Koopa Kid's name ahead of time because I got kind of lazy, like I sometimes do. Yeah, I just wanted to play today because I've been feeling that I've been getting a little bit rusty because I haven't been playing as often, so I'm going to try to play a little bit more, you know, keep the commentary going well and stuff like that. You know what I mean if you make walkthrough videos. That was a close one. And where? Oh, there's number one right there. And I'm guessing, yeah. Obviously, the gimmick of this castle is that the whole thing is moving. And there's spiky walls. That was awesome! Very well played, PkGam! So you gotta avoid the spiky walls while platforming. But I wanna get on top of this platform ahead of time so I can get the delicious prize that's within that box. And am I gonna have to go back to that side? That certainly seems like something I would have to do. Yup. Because I seen that there is a progressing couple platforms there. So, I see. I just seen a darker green wall there, and immediately my secret instincts go over there to touch the wall, and oh, I seen that there with that weird formation of coins, and okay, I'm gonna see how to do this one from like this side, because I'm guessing that they want me to do something from this side first, and then go back to the other side. Yeah, oh, no, aww. What a waste! I should have waited on that bottom tier to get that last coin. Oh well, I don't really need power-ups or lives anyway. Oh, which side do I... Oh, I see what side I want to do. I was going to say, which side do I want to go up? Probably the more dangerous one, and I was right! That one's very close to the spikes. And I got myself a springboard, which I can't use anywhere else except for here, which is a total shame, but I'm just... Oh, this is a lot more dangerous. It seems a lot more erratic than the other one. Like, something like that. Like, the space is different, then it moves a lot more. And it also seems a bit faster than the other one, which is to be expected as you get further up in the fortress. You expect it to be harder. And hello there. Oh, I'm gonna have to take a couple runs through this, aren't I? You sneaky, sly turkey. So, let's just, I'm just gonna jump for it, yeah, baby! And I'm going to do that, just to get myself prepared ahead of time so I have more room to jump, and there we go. Safe! And usually, oof, when there's an open area, there's a power-up, usually around here, so it's a good idea to check things. Like, I just got lucky and checked that wall, and yeah. Found the power up. That'll work for me. So let's go face what I hope is Iggy. Or I should say who I hope is Iggy. Hey, don't taunt me with your butt slapping. And your magic balls are pretty fast, but I am faster. And this is gonna make it extremely easy to dodge you, isn't it, with these platforms? Because they kind of alternate. So you're either on one side or the other, and you'll also most likely be on top of them. So this is gonna be like the easiest fight ever. So, look at that, he's gonna be on the bottom once again, so I can just jump right on top of him. And it's over! That was not hard at all. That was quite pathetic. I wonder if they, in testing, they thought that was gonna be, like, harder than the first boss fight or something like that. That was, like, basic platforming and enemies 101 there. And anyway, there's a secret exit in here, somewhere. I forgot where, though. So I'm gonna have to go back inside and take a look-see for that secret exit. At least I think there's a secret exit, if I'm not mistaken. I'm just gonna take a quick run through, see how it is, and I'll cut to where it is. And I just exited the stage. I was looking at, I should say I was thinking of something else, not looking at something else. What am I saying looking for? I don't know. That's what I mean about getting rusty. Anyway, let's go to 5-4 now. Get this sucker started. I believe there's only one secret exit stage in this world now, come to think of it, at the ghost house. Oh, this is one of those ones where enemies just plop onto your head and try and give you a concussion. I always wondered if you could get up there, like, without a propeller mushroom up on top of those Goombas. I don't think there is anything up there, but just thinking of that. Oh, this one. Oh, I shouldn't have got the ice flower. The trick of this one, you'll notice that there's numbers on the bottom of here. Well, when that number gets to 5, this platform will start sinking into the poisonous water stuff, whatever the heck this is. And you gotta clear off the platform before it's too late. And, oh, the poop, do I get up there? Well, I guess I'm not gonna find out. That was dumb. Okay, let's try this stage once again. I'm just gonna run through those Goombas because I was just messing around way too much at the beginning there. And now, maybe what they wanted me to do is use an ice flower to freeze an enemy to get up there or something like that. I'm not sure, honestly. I guess we're gonna find out once we get over there, both of us, because I kind of forgot, and I'm not gonna fall into the ooze, you know, accidentally, stupidly, like I did before, and I almost humped the Koopa there myself, so that wouldn't have been pretty good there, you know, touching the Koopa's backside, and okay, how? I can't get up there, I really can't get up there right now. Oh, I got a Goomba on my head anyway. I accidentally jumped right here, and there was a secret box set over here, and yeah, there's a power up here. But what I want to try is that ice flower, because I noticed that I came really close to touching that star coin before. So I'm going to attempt to freeze an enemy, preferably a Koopa, because they're taller than a Goomba, so I can jump on it like that and, you know, jump up to the star coin, obviously. And that one's gonna die off soon. Oh no, it doesn't die when it cracks open like that. Well, that works to my advantage then, doesn't it? I probably shouldn't have frozen right there, or maybe this will work. Maybe, yeah, that'll work. Woohoo! Okay, I finally got the coin. So, either an ice flower or a propeller mushroom will work. There's way too many enemies. Oh wait, it doesn't sink, but it does freeze into place. Why was I thinking it sinks? I don't know, I always seem to, my memories are always way off in my walkthroughs lately, I swear. maybe it's because these games are newer or something, and we got some micro Goombas here. They die just like normal Goombas, you stomp on them, but since they're so tiny, they're, needless to say, hard to kill off, because, you know, they're hard to jump on. And they also fill up this platform pretty dang quickly. And I'm at 0 right now. Power block. I bet you I need this for later, though. Poopers. That piranha plant's gonna cause trouble, isn't it? But I gotta just kill these off manually. If I'm not mistaken, I need this for something a little bit later. I think the star coin is up in those clouds. Oh, poopers. Oh, it just fell right into the toxic goop. Okay, I'm just gonna plop it here. Ah, it was over here. Okay, that was star coin number 2. And please stop with the ambushes. I can hear them. Ah! That was mean! Okay, we're down to 1 on the platform. Oh, come on! That was just mean! Where are they coming from? How will I stop the onslaught? I don't know, but I don't hear any more piranha plants. But there are some ba-bombs. That could be a problem. Oh, poopers. I needed a ba-bomb to go. Crappers! Break those blocks. Okay, we're coming up towards the end here, so grab up a bomb and plop it over there to destroy the blocks. Wait for that platform to come over here, so you are able to jump on top of it and get the glass coin. Yes, I did have to collect those first 2 coins again, but that's okay. and got all three coins in one run. That's pretty cool. Hey, how do you get up there? Do you have to do like a triple jump? That works. Yeah, okay, how do I get up to... Oh, that works too. Yay! Did I really need to do that seriously with 98 lives? Well, I had 97, but still. You know, I didn't want them to get too low, I guess. I admit that. And that'll split the path off to the ghost house as well as that level down there. I should probably go over to the ghost house. I think I have enough time to do it in this part, so I'm gonna just start it now and see how things turn out. So, let's start. 5-Ghost House. Oh, I remember this one. Maybe I won't have enough time for this one. This one's kind of stupid. There's a crap ton of doors around here. There's also, like, a bunch of blocks if you ever get, like, trapped down here to get yourself out if you have to. Most of the doors are fake and lead you back to the beginning, if I'm not mistaken. Like, I'm just gonna go up here and enter this door, and it'll lead me to... Oh, wait, this is a different place. I was expecting something entirely different, actually. I thought it takes you back to the beginning. Okay. Well, what's in here, anyway? There's some booze, obviously. Not the drink, Mr. Funny Man. Some ghosts. I got a light block. I can use that. And what's in here? Can I... Oh, okay. Just on the check the door there, just to make sure it's not enterable. And I'm sure most of these are fake, if not all of them, until, like, the secret ending passageway thingy. You know what I mean. So, I really don't remember this ghost house all that much, which is gonna suck, honestly, because this ghost house has a ton of doors, and that may be why I don't remember it. Well, there's the first star coin. I bet you this door leads back to the lobby. Okay, so I got that. Oh, and there's two exits in this one. So that's gonna be fun to find. Okay, so I checked that door. I'm going to go down this way and see. Wait, is there a block to escape this, or do I have to use the light block? I don't know. Okay, what's in this door? Is it another door that leads to that lantern? No, it's a totally different area. Okay, so I'm gonna consider this like area 3 or something. Oh, I shouldn't have thrown that block down there. There's some, as you can see, skeleton ghost fish down there. Skeleton fish, whatever you want to call them there. Fish bone, I believe they're called. Oh, there's coin number 2. I'm getting really lucky here, honestly. I seriously don't remember this, and I'm just getting really lucky with the coins, and I really shouldn't have thrown that light block away, but it still worked out well. So let's not worry about that, and move on ahead. So we've got another door there. 2 doors there, actually. I'm gonna take the left one. It's a fake door, of course. What about this one? Well, you can go on this one. So let's see what's in this one. there's a blue circle. I haven't seen them since Super Mario World, actually. They're dealt with the exact same way. There's just a little opening that you can go through. There's a little star coin! Wow! And that one's sticking his tongue out at me. That is a very lewd gesture that I do not approve of. Is there anything? No, there's nothing with those crates. Anyway, we're back to the start again! So, now all I have to do is get to the normal exit or the secret exit, whichever way that is. And why did I take that upper path? I don't know! Okay, so I'm just gonna go all the way to the end, because I'm almost positive that's where the normal exit is, not there. Wait. Aha! Maybe this was the secret exit? I will see in just a minute. Wait, totally different area, I guess. What is this, like, area 5 or something? I don't know. I just pressed the switch that makes this block solid. I hope I didn't press it. There's another switch over there to keep it going. I do remember this area. You just gotta keep that light switch or light block thingy there going. That was sneaky. Oh, Poopars, no! I have to get the coins again. Okay, this time, instead of going underneath here to that door. I'm going to... No, not that door. Maybe it was this door up here is the normal exit and the other one is the secret exit. I just want to escape the house unscathed, so to speak, with my 3 coins. And may I add that it's a lot easier to get through this place when you actually, you know what you're doing. Or I should say, when you're searching this place, it goes a lot faster, too. I can't break my way through these blocks. We've got some haunted blocks here going around, and I just got another one up like I needed that. wait, what is here? Just the one up. Do not care. Anything? Nothing there? Well, what's through this door? I don't know. I hope it's the normal exit. Oh, it is! Okay. So I'm gonna be back into that light block area, where that secret crate was, in just a second. So that's normal exit, all 3 coins. Be right back. And we're back over here, as you can see. So let's try that secret light block area, and hope for the best. Man, I'm already at like 23 minutes for this part. I'm gonna have a lot to chop off here. So I really look forward to the editing on this one. So let's just keep going and hope for the best, and of course not to die. Let's hope that the secret exit is this way. I'm almost positive it is this way, but you never know. Come on, come over this way this time. Am I gonna make it? Oh, I made it! Okay. Is there any secrets? I don't think so. So I'm just gonna go through this door. And what do I get? What do I get? This looks like it's gonna be the secret exit. Wait. I just wanted to check that door for the fun of it. And we got a boo ring. We got a classic staircase like Mario 1. And these boos obviously aren't that shy because they keep going around you in circles while looking at you. And the secret exit! So, that's all for this part. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next one. By the way, this leads to the canon of the world.